oldest of theaters, an oversized fun.
Two real people keeping history alive in their own way. On Route 66, you never know what or who you'll discover next.
Route 66, can you believe it, Mama?
Big deal. I'm Rodney Miller.
And I'm Jan Carl.
You know, Route 66 is probably the most famous road in America.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided to do a series of episodes covering it from Chicago all the way to Santa Monica.
Right now, we are in Oklahoma, which gets to lay claim to the longest, most uninterrupted stretch of that mother road. So let's go.
Leaving Kansas, we head into Oklahoma's 375-mile stretch of Route 66 adventures. We pass through Commerce on our way to our first stop, Miami.
And that is the correct Oklahoma way of saying the town's name.
A must-see here is the beautiful Coleman Theater, where director Danny Dillon and his staff helped us see that this isn't just a beautiful structure, it's a presence and strength in the community.
I'm like blown away. It reminds me of the Fox in Atlanta. How did this come about?
Well, George Coleman made a contract with the top vaudeville traveling act, but he had to promise them a theater like they were used to performing in Atlanta and New York City. So this place was open for business in April of 1929, and it has never closed its doors.
Wait, wow. It's never closed its doors?
Nope.
But there were some dark days.
In the mid-80s, it was in such terrible shape, and the people in the community, they've done all of the fundraising, and all of this refurbishment has been done just by volunteers.
The Coleman is a perfect example of what can be achieved when communities are united. It can produce so much good.
And speaking of good, you know, Jen and I have a few pretty good talents we don't often talk about. But playing the organ isn't one of them.
It's now time for an iconic Route 66 lunch, and I'm thinking this stop could be named for Rodney.
Well, I am crazy for hamburgers, and Waylon's were superior.
Wow. How long have you owned this restaurant?
I've been here for 47 years.
Wow.
Been back here in 1973.
Great hamburger.
Well, thank you.
That's his third one.
Everything here is made to order. The nostalgia is free of charge.
Next, a very rare 9-foot-wide stretch of road known as the Route 66 Ribbon Road, or the Sidewalk Highway.
So legend has it that when they went to put this road in, they only had enough money to go either the full distance across the county at half the width, or they could have gone half the distance at full width. This is what they arrived at. This is the original asphalt and the original concrete. In the entire country, this is the only place you're going to find a 9-foot-wide sidewalk highway anywhere.
Back on the two-lane in Afton, the Avon Motor Court, built in 1936, still has three of the remaining cabins standing. It's a favorite photo stop among Route 66 road warriors today. After crossing this beautiful bridge in Chelsea, a field of totem poles and other unique art is waiting just 4 miles off Route 66 at Ed Galloway's Totem Pole Park in Foyle, Oklahoma. An expert woodworker and artist, Mr. Galloway taught woodworking at a nearby orphanage until he retired to this land.
Standing at 90 feet, it's here he built the world's tallest concrete totem pole, as well as smaller ones and unique furniture.
He also built a fiddle house for all of his beautiful violins. Each one is crafted from a different type of tree. There's even one built of poison oak. I wonder if musicians are just itching to play that one.
We've had all 50 United States and 72 foreign countries. So I've had people from all over the world that walk in this door, and it's just amazing.
Ed Galloway's creative legacy lives on for the world to enjoy.
If you think a 90-foot-tall totem pole is cool, how about an 80-foot-long whale? In Catoosa, Oklahoma, you can't miss the smiling blue Route 66 icon.
Its creator, Hugh Davis, the director of the Tulsa Zoo for 34 years, built his most famous animal as an anniversary gift for his wife, Zelta. Soon, they expanded their family fun to the public.
With all your years here volunteering, what do you see on the faces of the children?
Magic.
If they could step sideways just a little bit, they could step into the 70s, where it was a more peaceful, calming time, and people weren't afraid to follow their dreams and passion.
People will look back on these times and say, gosh, I wish we could go back in time.
I wish we could go back in time. I love the fact that he just thought, I can do this. He did it.
That's a lot of what Route 66 gives you when you travel the historic byway. It's a step back to a simpler time. A time that if you can dream it, you can do it.
So back in the day, there was a diamond board on top of it.
It's a good reminder of what we can be if we try.
Hello! Stay right there. We'll be back with more big dreams and giant surprises on Route 66.
But first, can you guess what event drew crowds and cameras to the 9-foot ribbon highway of Route 66 in 1928? Was it the All-American Soapbox Derby, the Bunyan Derby, or a parade for the newly elected president, Herbert Hoover? The answer, when we come right back.